You're about to learn how to create the Vertigo effect to make your drone or gimbal shots a tad more interesting.
But first, if you're new to the channel, my name is Sebastian and I create weekly tutorials on DaVinci Resolve, so if that's something you guys are interested in, please consider hitting that subscribe button. But for now, let's jump into the fun part.
So guys, creating this Vertigo zoom effect inside of DaVinci Resolve is actually very, very simple. As I first saw this effect, I thought there was some crazy fusion stuff going on, but turned out it actually isn't. All there is to it is 4 keyframes on zoom and position, and that's about it. So let me just show you how to create this effect, because that is really crazy simple. All you need to pull off this effect is a clip where the camera is pushing in a straight line or pushing out in a straight line. And that's about it. When you got something like that, you're pretty much set up for success, but there's one more thing to it. Make sure that you use a stabilizer, because there's nothing worse than making this effect on shaky footage. So make sure you're either using a drone, a steadicam or a glide cam, a gimbal, a slider, or whatever kind of stabilization that you need. If you don't have any form of stabilization, make sure to move as steady as you can and then try to stabilize the clip in post. If it works, great. This is the clip that we're working on. So this is just a clip from my recent vacation in Sweden. So as you see, the drone is just flying backwards. And all we need in order to make this effect happen is set a keyframe on the very first frame of this clip in the inspector on zoom and on precision. Now then, what you want to do is move to the end, or let's say something right there, because when I move to the end, I'm too far off of my subject and I have to punch in a crazy amount, and because this is filmed in 4K, I can only punch in like 200% to not lose that much amount of quality. All right, so let's reset that here, there, perfect. Go back to the first frame, set a keyframe on zoom and precision, then move along in your timeline to a point where you're satisfied, let's say right there, set a keyframe once again. Now let's move back to the first frame. Now take an imaginary picture of the frame right there. Okay, subject is in the middle of the frame, but somewhere a little bit down. Then what we want to do is move to the next keyframe, and all we want to do there is punch in a crazy amount of time like this, and then we want to reframe the shot something like that, so our subject stays in relatively the same space. And once we've done that, we're pretty much finished. All we gotta do is go to the first frame and hit play to see this effect. So guys, this is it. This is how crazy simple it is to pull off the Vertigo zoom effect.
Now that's a wrap guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already, to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to even more people that might be interested in that specific topic. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching. Hope you all have a great day. See you guys in the next one. Bye.